You ready to kick it with Kenny?
Let's kick it.
Well, let's do it. Mr. Crumpton, good morning, my friend.
Good morning, Wayne and Chrissy. We are kicking glass with Chris and his crew here at the Glass Asylum. Good to see you, man.
Good to see you, too.
All right, we're going to see something really cool right here. Well, let's explain what's happening. Give us the John Madden. Give us a play-by-play what we're seeing here, Chris.
Well, Bridget's currently heating up a piece of color bar.
Okay.
It's actually blue-colored when it's going to be done.
Okay.
Ryan has a clear bubble set up on his pipe, mm-hmm. and they are going to combine the two to create a blue piece of glass that we'll see later today.
That's really cool. And so mm-hmm. this is the bread and butter of the Glass Asylum. You guys, you know, you do some really cool stuff during the holiday and throughout the year where people get a chance to actually not only watch glass art being made, mm-hmm. but they get a chance to,
take
part in themselves. Yeah. And that's been really cool. But this, the Glass Asylum 2, you guys have kicked it up a notch, right?
We have kicked it up a notch. So yeah, we created a really nice event space over there in showroom.
Mm-hmm.
We've created different little art areas so we can expand our installations and show the public how we can create installations as a whole studio. So I have a lot of talented artists that work here and not only create glass, but they have other artistic talents as well. So we use mixed medias to create real neat installations over there.
Right, that's really cool. And you know, it's also another way for you to give the public a chance to have another great place with artistic accents to throw an event.
Yes. So we can throw an event over there. The facility holds up to 100 people.
Okay.
We cater in food. You know, there's beverages there.
Okay.
And you can have any type of an event that you can think of.
That's pretty cool. Now you had we did an art installation with you out at the Botanical Garden. How did that go?
It went really great. I mean, we were honored to be a part of that. We got to house about 1,000 pieces of glass down at the Botanical Gardens last summer, so about May to October. And we had a really, really neat responses from it. And
that's
it was
cool.
Fun to be a part of something down in Cleveland and in a public space.
And I think that was really cool how your art was being displayed there at the Botanical Gardens. You know, of course, we'll see your art in the art gallery, but it really showed the diversity of how your art can be displayed in such a really cool venue.
Yes. And if you look closely, you'll see some of the botanical gardens.
Yeah, I see that.
Leftover pieces sitting here. You'll see them at the other facility as well.
Yeah.
And then,
that's awesome. How's the response been with the Glass Asylum 2 so far?
It's been phenomenal.
Yeah.
Everybody seems to love it. It's an interesting space because it's Instagram, but it's off the beaten path a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just a big warehouse that
we
turned
into. What are we seeing here, Chris?
We are seeing those guys create a lighting fixture.
Okay.
So it's a unique light fixture that they're making. It's a very difficult one.
Yeah,
it's a big heavy hot piece of glass that they're working with.
Yeah.
That's why it takes a lot of agility to create that piece.
You aren't kidding, man. Yeah, that's not painting something on canvas, no offense.
But
big physical piece. All right, when we come back, we're going to take a look at the Glass Asylum 2 and see how the art you see here can be displayed there. And you can have it as a piece of your events when we come back. It's going to be cool.
Yep,
all right, let's go back to you guys in the studio.
Sounds good. Thank you, Kenny.